Hello children, so we will continue with the same chapter. The name of the chapter is the same, the living organism characteristics and habitat. We have already studied the beginning of the chapter in which we have discussed about the biotic-abiotic components. We have discussed about the what is habitat, what is adaptations. And now we are discussing about the different types of habitats. I told you that the habitat is of two types. One is the terrestrial and second one is the aquatic. Terrestrial habitat is those habitat where we find the living organisms like plants and animals living on the land with the interaction of abiotic components, that is known as the terrestrial. And aquatic are those, aquatic habitats are those where we find the plants and animals living in a water. So we have discussed the terrestrial. We have discussed the terrestrial habitat in which we have already discussed the desert and mountain. And we find the comparison between that the deserts. In desert area, there is a temperature is quite high, and the animals and the plants they are living there, having some adaptations, and that adaptations help them to survive in this extreme condition. On the other hand, we have already discussed about the mountain habitats, and there we find that the area is quite hilly and temperature is quite low. We find a different kind of vegetations, animals and plants there according to their climatic condition, and they have some adaptations which helps them to survive in the low temperature. So next is the grassland. Okay, as the name suggests, grasslands, that means that land area where we find mostly the medium sized shrubs, that is a grass. Okay, we don't find the trees, tall trees there. Mostly that whole area is covered by the grass sized vegetation, that is known as a grassland. As you know, that means grassland means the grasses are quite medium sized. So there the living organisms there having some more adaptation. We find that in the grassland area mostly it is these grasses mostly is in the yellowish and the brown in color, and they need a tentative temperature, moderate temperature, and there is a moderate rainfall is there. So you will find the diversities of grasslands there. You will find the shrubs of grass size there. Now second thing, you will find that in the grassland area or in the grassland habitat, we find that the plants are of medium size. The grasses should be of medium size like this, in this way. Okay, so it is of medium size and it is covered the long long distance of the lands. Next is the animals. Now because the area having medium sized grassland area, and they don't have dense forest, don't have a dense plants, trees there, so the animals which are living there are commonly lion, tiger, deer, fox, hyena. Okay, now what kind of adaptation they have to exist so that they can be survive in that conditions. So lion, tiger, first we talk about the lion, tiger. You all of you have seen the color of that. They have the yellowish and brown in color, so that they can easily hide themselves behind this shrubs, behind this medium sized grasslands. Whenever the predator is going to attack on the prey, on their prey. So that means their color should be of brown in color. Their color should be of light yellowish in color or muddy in color. Or you can say the organisms which are living in this area should having this kinds of color, like brown, yellow, yellowish color, or even muddy color there. Next thing is that you will see the eyes of the lion, tiger. It should be on the front. Why it is on front? So that it can be keep eye on the prey, so that it can easily attack on the prey. So that's why they having the eyes, so that they can just focus on the target. Next, their legs. Have you seen the paws of the lion and tiger? It is very strong. Okay, so their paws are quite strong, hard, so that whenever they attack on the prey, that prey will not able to escape out of that. Okay, so their paws should be very strong, and their claws are quite sharp. So whenever it attack on the body, it always attack on the neck region. Okay, so whenever it attack on the body, their claws will come out and they just make a grip on the particular part of the animal. Okay, so that means that claws will be come out whenever the animal is ready to attack. After that, while walking, their claws will be move inside or withdraw inside the paw. So that is one of the most important character of the these animals of cat family, like lion, tiger, leopard and all. Next is that their forelimbs are quite strong, because I told you with their forelimbs they attack on the prey. Next is the deer, because in that same place you will find the deer is also existing, hyena is also existing, fox is also living there. So their front eyes, you will find their eyes should be on the front, okay, so that they can see both the sides. If you see that they're having a snout on the side of their body, they find the two eyes, okay, so both the eyes can see the both side of the places, so that they can detect the danger or they can detect the predator. First thing, they having a ears over the head, so that they can hear or sensitize the vibration. They can sense the vibration of a sound, so that they can find whether there is a danger or not. So they having these two features. Along with this, they having a strong jaw, so that they can easily chew the branches, hard branches of the plants. Okay. So this is the characteristics, or these are the adaptations of the animals, those who are living in the grassland area. Okay, so there is a lots of animals living in there. So this is all about the terrestrial habitat. We have discussed three terrestrial habitat: desert, mountain and grassland. And on three of them, when you compare, you will find a lot of differences about their vegetations, about their habitat, about their adaptations and the plants. Now let's move on to the next, that is an aquatic habitat. Aquatic, as the name suggests, that means plants and animals or the organism living in a water, that is known as aquatic habitat. And we know that the aquatic habitat is of two types. One is the ocean, second one is the pond, lakes or rivers, or your freshwater habitats. Okay, so first we discuss about the oceans. We know that in the ocean there is a lots of water is there, and that water is boundless and it's having endless boundaries. Okay, so in this we find that the animals which are living in the ocean, okay, you find that the animals living in the ocean, it should having a streamlined body. Its body should be streamlined like this. Okay, now why it is of streamlined? So that whenever it is passes through the water current, the water can easily move away. First thing. Second thing, the animals having the gills. If you see on the near the air, they will find the gills. Now what is the function of these gills? These gills help to use the oxygen. When the fish inhale water, we know that the fish or the aquatic animal, mostly they take oxygen from the water. So they inhale the water from the mouth, and from the mouth that oxygen is taken by the gills and it is transported to the whole part of the body, and water is moved out through the gills. So that means gills help to take on the oxygen and transport to the whole part of the body of a aquatic organism. First thing. Now next, they having the fins. Okay. Now what is the function of these fins and the tails? They help to swim easily in the water. Okay. Fins and tails help them to swim in the water, and they can be turned any way. Okay. Or by any moment they can turn and twist. So that is the function. So that these are the features which helps them to stay in the water. Okay, so that means they having a streamlined body, they having a gills and fins, and mostly when you see about the dolphins and the whale, mostly it is found in the ocean. So they don't have a gills. So how do they breathe? So they having a blowholes. They having a blowholes, and they always remain on the nearby the water level, so that whenever there is a shortage of water, they take the water from the air. So it come out from the water. Okay, it come out from the water, inhale air, and then swim in the water, and it can be stay without oxygen for a long time. So it can just move out from the water and take oxygen from the air. Okay, so that is one of the feature of this whales and dolphins, because they have the lungs, they don't have a gills. Okay, and they have that nose nostril that we call as blowholes, and mostly we will find that the whales and dolphins, they come up out of the water and swim and jump like this. The reason for that, to get the air or to get the oxygen. This is the features of aquatic habitat. Now move on to the second aquatic habitat, that is the habitats of ponds, lakes, rivers. Okay, rivers you will find that the running water is there, but in the ponds and lake there is a water is stagnant, and you will find in the stagnant water, okay, you will find a lot of plantation and vegetation on the bottom because it's not very deep. So you will find a lots of vegetation existing at the bottom. You will find most of the vegetation existing at the bottom of the ponds and the lakes, and these having a root, that roots are not too much penetrated. Okay, it's not deeply penetrated, or its roots are for only to absorb the nutrition from the bottom of the lake that having a soil. Okay, the first feature is that means their roots are fixed, so that whenever there is a movement in the water, that will be helps to keep the plant stick on the water. Okay, second thing is that if you see the leaves and the stems of this plant mostly is hollow. Okay, if you see the stems of rest of the plant, you will find it should be having dense, but here you will find it is hollow, so that it helps to swim or float in the water. And when you see the leaves, mostly you find the leaves in the water is just like this. It should be divided. Okay, it never like a big leaf. Okay, it never like be a big leaf. It is bifurcated, or you can say bifurcated in the sense it is having like this. Okay, so that the whenever the water is passes through it, it never damages the leaf. Second thing, its leaves should be of ribbon like this. Okay, it helps to pass the water easily, and it won't damage the leaf. So that is the vegetation of the plants living or the plants growing in the water, that their leaves and their stems should be hollow. Leaves are the having a bifurcations, or they having the ribbon like structures, or they are divided. Okay, next is when we see about the animals living in this pond, lakes and the rivers, we find that mostly there were some water snakes and some of the frogs you will find. And you know that the frogs can live both on the land and the water, so frogs have both lungs and the gills, so that they can easily stay in both the places. But when we see about the body or limbs of the frog, you will find that their forelimbs, as compared to their forelimbs, their hind limbs are much stronger, and they can easily leap and catch the prey. Second thing, if you see the web of the frog, that means if you see the forelimbs, the paw of the frog, you will find there it is webbed. Webbed in the sense you will find that just like this. Okay, so this is the web structure. So this web structure, what it helps to swim in a water. So this is a adaptation that helps the organism to survive in a aquatic habitat. So this is all about the habitat. We have completed the two topics. One is a terrestrial habitat, and second one is a aquatic habitat. Hope you understood. So after this, watching this video, just go through the chapter to make you more understand. Thank you.